Hi guys, this is Zach from Watches on You, and today I'm going to be taking a look at a very special piece. This is the Omega Seamaster 300 from 1970, reference 166024. Now, this watch is just coming to a lot more popularity recently with the release of the Omega Trilogy, which has the original Speedmaster, Railmaster, and Seamaster, but this is the actual Seamaster 300 from the time period. So now I'm going to go over the overall aesthetics and a little bit of the history of this piece. So this watch is a stainless steel case, and you can see a lot of elements in it that is still included on Omega watches today. One of which being the flowing bevel going from lug to lug on both sides, which is really seen in all of their watches, and it gives Omegas that classic, nice classic look. And one other thing is the bezel. Now the bezel it's just very clean on this piece, and you can see a lot of similarities between this bezel and the bezel that's on the new remake of the Seamaster 300. And it just looks absolutely fantastic. I really like it. I like how the numbers are a different shade than the standard indices, and I really like that. And it is also a 60-click bidirectional bezel, instead of the new one, which is, of course, only unidirectional. And so this watch is, it's really nice. I like how thin it is. It's very, very thin. And a lot of the older watches tend to be thinner than the modern day equivalents. And I really like that. I like how thin it is for a sports watch. I mean, obviously it's not as thin as a dress watch, but it is a lot thinner than the new equivalents, which I really like. One other thing about this, so now moving on to the dial. Now the dial is a matte black dial, and you can see the lume there, which is patinaed absolutely beautifully. And then you can see that nice sword hour hand right there, the sword hands, and you can see some of the lume has fallen out of the hour hand. But re-luming this, really, I mean, being that it's such a vintage piece, that probably wouldn't be the right decision to go with. Now, it also has that nice white second hand, which is actually the same that's seen on the Speedmaster, and it just looks absolutely great. I mean, it's super clean, very classic sporty, and it just offers a very, very nice vintage look that's going to be just very unique in when you wear it around town. I mean, it's going to be a little bit more special than what other people would be wearing, for sure. So now, one other interesting thing about this watch is actually, as you can see on the case back, that's a Speedmaster case back. Now, that's not because this is a Franken watch. This is an original piece, and that the reason it actually has a Speedmaster case back is because Omega, at the time, if they had a shortage of parts, they would just interchange things. So this is the same size, and they must have had a shortage of Seamaster case backs, so they decided, hey, let's just put on some Speedmaster case backs. Now, you're not really going to notice that in everyday life, but that's a very interesting thing that this watch has on it. But the way you can actually tell that this isn't a replaced case back and it is the original is by looking on the inside of it and seeing that the model numbers and serial numbers match up, which on this piece it does. So another thing about this watch is this is actually the European model, so it has a different movement than the US model, and the reason they did that was because they wanted to assemble the movements in the US in order to avoid tariffs that were put on certain exports. And so this one has the European movement, which is just a little different. The movements, they're the same in functionality. This one's just a bit different in that aspect, as it has a different number, which is the 565. So now I'm going to move on to a wrist shot. So on the wrist, this watch is great. I mean, the size perfectly fits my wrist. Mine is a 7-inch wrist, so as you can see, I really like it. I mean, I think it's perfect. I love these old vintage dive watches, and the Omega is just very, very special. You're obviously not going to see this as much as a vintage Rolex Submariner, but I mean, and that's one of the reasons I really like it. It looks absolutely fantastic. It's got a great history, and it's just, I just love it. I mean, it fits my wrist great, very comfortable. Fantastic. Now the strap that this watch actually has is a Cordovan leather strap, and not the original. The original, it does have the bracelet, but on this piece, the owner decided to replace it with a Cordovan strap, as the true bracelet was a little bit beat up. So overall, this is a great vintage piece, and it's a lot more unique than a Rolex Submariner, as it just got a totally different look, and you're not really going to see it. Not as many people bought these. So overall, I really like this piece. It's a great vintage watch, and I think that if you're looking at a vintage dive watch, this is definitely a model you need to consider. So thank you for watching this video. Remember to like, subscribe, and share. Thank you.